And this morning, I discussed with Minister Baerbock how imperative it is for all states' parties to truly commit to their obligations and responsibilities under the Paris Agreement. The Philippines, by virtue of its geographic circumstances and location, is one of the most disaster-prone countries in the world, which is why making the country climate smart and disaster ready is a priority of the Philippine government. And we know we have a reliable partner in this regard with the German government. This is important because the climate change issues for countries such as the Philippines is also a security issue. Rising temperatures have led to more extreme and more frequent weather events, as we have seen over the past few years. And this leads to loss of infrastructure, destruction of harvests, and the livelihoods of people. And it is a boon to be able to work and discuss this issue with countries such as Germany under the Indo-Pacific guidelines, which have committed to tackling climate change and protecting the environment. And this is about all that I wish to say this morning. We and the Philippine government are really truly excited to enhance our relationship with Germany in all the areas that we have mentioned this morning and to continue our work with our German counterparts on these issues. I wish to thank again once Minister Baerbock for your having us here and for the excellent arrangements and generous hospitality you have extended to me and my delegation. And we look forward to having further discussions in the days ahead and, of course, hopefully, an invitation for you to visit us in Manila. Thank you.
Thank you. We have time for a few questions.
Good morning, Frau Ministerin.
Madam Minister, President Macron suggested at the security conference in Munich to set up a common European shield of deterrence. What is your position in that regard? Minister, you mentioned Ukraine. What do you expect of China's suggestion for a peace plan, which will probably present it on the anniversary of the beginning of the war? Will this end the war? And do you think that Ukraine has to win this war? In the face of Russia's brutal war of aggression, we in NATO, but also within the European Union, have been intensively focusing over the last year on ensuring and enhancing our ability to defend ourselves. This is the purpose of the strategic concept of NATO, which has been redrafted, and the foreign and security policy guidelines of the European Union. And it is in that context that we are developing a new national security strategy for Germany. Over the past few months, the Federal Chancellor has underlined how important air defense is for Europe as a whole. As far as the nuclear issue is concerned, you may know that nuclear sharing is something that we engage on with the United States, and we have prepared the ground for that, and we will continue to work on this also as we develop the Federal Armed Forces and work on our budget. So it's an overall picture, and of course we coordinate and exchange views with our partners, and that includes France, of course.
On the question of the proposal of China on the Ukraine, of course, this was only presented the other day at the Munich Security Conference, and we will obviously need time to go over it. But our position has been very clear, that we would support any proposal which would lead to a peaceful solution, which is, of course, acceptable to the parties concerned, especially Ukraine. If the details of that proposal do address these, then the Philippines would, of course, be very happy to support any effort towards that end.
Next question, Mr. Schmidt. Madam Minister, the American president is visiting Poland, or will visit Poland. Would you have wished for him to also drop in Berlin? Because he wasn't here at the time that the G7 summit took place. Important talks could take place. There is every reason for such talks. What is the position of the government in that regard? What we haven't lacked last year, I want to be very clear, is a very close exchange between Germany and the United States. It's just as close as And I think it's fair to say that never before has this friendship as close as it has been over the past year or so. The visit of the American president to Poland is very important to us. It is the immediate neighbor of Ukraine, and it plays a decisive part in providing support and providing arms to Ukraine. It is also one country that is of importance for us. We're talking about maintenance work on and repair work that needs to be carried out with weapons provided. Thus, such a visit by the American president to Poland is also in our interest. Last question, Mr. Feld. You mentioned the resolution of March. How confident are you that on the occasion of the anniversary, the UN Assembly will once again send out a strong signal? And an additional question, if I may, the net has been very negative because you spoke of a 360-degree turnaround. It's clear what you wanted to say. Do you have the feeling that your words are being weighed extremely carefully? The next few days will be decisive, not only with an eye to Ukraine, but also for peace in the world. In a way, summarize, you know, this week in New York, in a way, summarizes the past year. The world has been united in condemning Russia's war of aggression. When we passed the resolution last year in March, there were but a handful of countries left that supported Russia at all. There were a few countries at the time that abstained, and also abstained through the course of the year, but not because they did not condemn Russia's war of aggression or did not support the United Nations, but because they are in a massive dependency on Russia and have been massively dependent on Russia. What we've been able to achieve together last year is that we have been very clear in condemning this violation of international law and in its support for the Charter of the United Nations. And we will do the same on Thursday and Friday this week when I travel to New York. My Philippine colleague has underlined that in very impressive words a minute ago. This war is not a European affair. It's not a European matter because it has terrible consequences and terrible impact on the rest of the world. And this is why the world at large appeals to the Russian president these days in New York to end this terrible war, to withdraw his troops, and to finally make sure that peace returns. Thank you very much. This conference is concluded.